We now need the bust width. Our back bust width was the across back measurement of 13.5 inches halved. That's 6¾ inches. And with 2 inches added to give us 8¾ inches. Calculate half bust measurement and plus 2 inches. So in this case, half the bust measurement, 33.5 inches plus 2 inches, is 18¾ inches. Take away the 8¾ inches from 18¾ inches, leaving us 10 inches for the front bust width to the underarm point. At the chest line, we want to find the chest point. Measure along from centre front a half chest width, adding on the dart width at this point. My half chest width is 6.5 inches and the dart width at this level measures 3/4 inch. So chest point CP is 7¼ inches from CF. Draw a line from shoulder point to chest point. Then drop a vertical line to the bust line. This is a guide for the armhole shape. Find the midpoint along the SP-CP line and measure 1/2 inch inside it. Then find the point 1/2 inch from the angle on the 45-degree line. So we can now draw the armhole line, dipping below the bust line here, and passing through all these points to the shoulder. This curve will match up with the shallower curve of the back armhole. You could use a French curve template, but I prefer to do it by eye and get exactly what I want. This diagram shows what we have just done. From hip point on the front bodice, measure 1/4 hip measurement plus 1½ inches. Join UP and HP for the hip seam guide. Mark waist point about 1/2 inch from this line and 1/4 inch below the waistline and draw in the side seam. Draw the true bust line 2 inches below the bust line guide. Where this line crosses the line down from the bust dart point, mark with an X as the highest point of the bust. For a true waist, we already have the WP a little lower on the waistline guide. Mark the front waist point a half an inch lower at centre front. Larger sizes drop the centre front waist point up to an inch and up to a half an inch at the side seam. You'll find all these diagrams in the PDF. To properly cut the shoulder dart, find the centre of the dart and fold . Pin the dart with the fold towards the neckline and redraw the shoulder line from NP to SP. Unpin and draw in the extended dart lines. You'll notice this line is redrawn a fraction higher now. Check the armhole measurement. It should be 4.5 to 5 inches larger than the top arm measurement. My top arm measurement is 11.5 inches. So 16 to 16.5 inches would be right for the armhole measurement. A quarter of an inch difference is okay. Finally, make sure you label your block with these details at least, and any other notes to remind you of variations you may want to finalise when you try your block for size. This block is the basis for dresses without a waist seam, jackets and coats. There is no allowance for ease. Ease is added at design stage. From this draft, we can work on the short bodice block, adding dart shaping at the waist, and we will also be using it to draft a sleeve block.